Hi, Thomas here. I'm sure you're familiar with Windows Admin Center, our web-based management solution for Windows workloads, clusters, and even Azure Stack HCI. Now, you can download it today. You can install it in your on-premises environment, at other cloud providers, or even in an Azure VM to manage your Windows workloads. However, if you're running your Windows servers inside Azure, wouldn't it be great if you could leverage the Azure portal to basically get the management experience from Windows Admin Center? So that is exactly what I'm going to show you today. So stay tuned. So as mentioned, Windows Admin Center is a great way of managing your Windows servers and clusters running on premises or even in the cloud. Now, since we have Azure, wouldn't it be great if I would not even need to go and connect to a Windows Admin Center platform or just use the Azure portal basically to manage my Windows server machines? So with the new integration of Windows Admin Center in the Azure portal, I can do exactly that. So here I'm in the Azure portal with an Azure machine. And as you can see here in the menu, you can see here on the settings, Windows Admin Center. So if the first time I click on this, I can basically get some information that I actually need to set this up. I can also find some more information what I can do with Windows Admin Center. And you can see here, I need to install the extension so I can manage that. So for that, I just hit install. And this will then install the Windows Admin Center extension. Now, as you can see here, there is an inbound port. So if you want to use the public IP address to manage that specific server, you will now open that up in your network security group to make sure that you can actually reach that for the virtual machine. However, with the latest preview, with the public preview, we can also leverage private IP addresses to manage our Windows VMs running in Azure. Now, the installation of the Windows Admin Center extension can take up to like 5 minutes. So we will speed up that process a little bit here with a couple of tricks in video editing. So after the Windows Admin Center extension was successfully installed, we can now see the following screen where I actually can select with what kind of like IP address I want to connect to that Azure virtual machine. So with that, I just want to use the private IP address. I click on connect. And I will need to provide obviously my credentials. So in this case, my username and password. And after I'm signed in, I will get my Windows Admin Center experience directly within the Azure portal. So you can see here, I can directly get my overview about my Windows Server machine here. I can get a computer name, which operating system I'm running. I get all that information directly within the Azure portal without even connecting to that specific virtual machine. On the left side, you can also see all the tools and extensions we are basically using. So for example, I can do certificate management, device management. I can access event logs of that machine. So I can directly see, for example, like let's go into the system event log here and I can browse the system event log and can see what's going on. I can manage files and file shares, the firewall, local users, and much, much more. One thing I want to show you, by the way, is also I can, for example, go in and do some use the new performance monitoring tool. So I just hit that menu item and I can just create a blank workspace here. And now I can, for example, go out and add some of the objects. So let's do processor. I can tell you like which instances. In my case, let's take all, select the counters. So let's say, just do processor time here. And now I can get statistics here. I can see the graph for this, what is going on. I can also, like, let's say want to add something else. I can also change that and get some better information. And depending on what I choose, I can also change the graph type here, depending on what I want. So if I want to compare it with the processor time, I can go from report, or I can just go into the line mode again. And as I would do same with Windows Admin Center on premises. What is also very interesting, so if I want to have an interactive PowerShell session, I can also click here on PowerShell. In that sense, it will ask me for my password again. And just log in, and you can see here I have my password and my PowerShell session directly from within the Azure portal. So if I type here host name, you will see that this is actually my server I'm managing here. I can even see some, like, the processes running. I can do a remote registry, so I have a web-based registry editor right here. So if I want to do some changes to the registry keys, I can do that as well. I can install roles and features, create some scheduled tasks, and also I can always use remote desktop directly within the Windows Admin Center experience in the Azure portal. And again, it will take a while until it's loaded. I will need my credentials. I can actually confirm and connect, and this will now make basically provide me with a remote desktop session within the browser to the specific virtual machine here as well. And so with that, I can really start managing my Windows server running in Azure without the need of connecting to any jump host or anything. It makes it super easy to actually manage that server from the Azure portal. I hope this video provided you with a short overview about how you can leverage Windows Admin Center directly within the Azure portal. If you liked that video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel.